इन
what
कैश बुक वी रिकॉर्ड ट्रांजैक्शंस रिलेटेड टू कैश
रिलेटिंग टू कैश इनफ्लो एंड आउटफ्लो
यस
ओके एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैश बुक हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ कैश बुक आर देयर
सिंगल कॉलम कैश बुक डबल कॉलम कैश बुक
ट्रिपल कॉलम
कैश ट्रिपल
There is no triple column cash
no,
book.
No, sorry. A petty cash book.
Yeah, so that is different. For now, we are just discussing about
yes,
the...
Yes, sir, two types.
The simple cash book. There is a... Yeah. So there are two types of cash book. Simple cash book and the two column cash book. All right. So Halima, yes, can you tell me in the single column cash book, what kind of transactions are recorded? What kind of transactions are recorded in the single column cash book? Only... bank transactions are recorded only cash transactions are recorded or both the transactions are recorded in the single column cash book tell me please do it fast Halima
yes sir
what kind of transactions are recorded in the single column cash book
Related to cash
only, right?
Yes.
And in the double column cash book?
Cash and bank,
correct. Okay. So this is the format. If you remember the cash book, this is the format for the cash book. We have two sides, left side and the right side. In the left side, we record all the cash inflows. And in the right side, we record all the outflows of the cash.
Outflows.
So left side is called the debit side and the right side is called the credit side. All right. So let's start with this question. Okay. So come on, everyone. Please draw the format of the cash book first of all and start recording this transaction and let me know the final balance. Let me know the balance, closing balance of the cash book. Do it fast. Yeah, I want to know the buy balance CD.
Buy balance PD, right? CD.
By balance?
Yes, CD.
CD.
Yes, CD.
And keep asking me if you find any difficulty in the question. Any problem if you're having. Especially yes, Halima, if you are not comfortable with any transaction or entry, do let me know, please. You never ask any question. Neither you give any answers. All right, so Mr. Vipin commenced business with cash. Tell me, Halima, on which side of the cash book this will be recorded? This will be recorded on the debit side or the credit side? And by what name it will be recorded, Halima?
By capital.
Oh, on the credit side or the debit side?
Debit.
Debit side, two capital. Okay?
Yes, two capital.
Okay. Next, open a bank account and deposit it 75,000. Halima, Sameeksha. Open a bank account and deposit 75,000. On which side of the cash book it will be recorded?
The credit side.
Credit side. Open a bank account and deposit.
Bank account? Two bank account.
Yeah. So, okay. So we are basically... No, two bank... It will not be two bank account.
Bank account we are opening. So...
So cash will be deposited there, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the cash will reduce, no?
So by cash account.
Yeah, by cash. Yes. By bank. No. On the credit side of the cash book, we will write by bank account.
By bank account, yes.
Yeah.
But sir, cash will also reduce, right?
That is what I'm doing now.
Yes, sir.
When so cash reduces, yes. we enter the transaction on the credit side of the cash book.
Yes.
And we are currently making the single column cash book, Sameeksha.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Therefore, we won't be recording the bank transactions.
Yes.
That means the banking, by how bank will get affected, we are not concerned about that.
Yes, sir.
For goods, sir. All right. So, purchase goods for cash. Halima, purchase goods for cash. On which side of the cash book this will be recorded? Do it fast. Come on. Tell me. Purchase goods for cash. Debit side,
we are credited.
Credit, goods, correct.
Credited.
And it will be credited by what name?
Goods.
It will be, no, by purchase account.
By purchase account.
By purchase. Whenever goods are purchased, we will write purchase account only. Okay?
Okay.
Again, Sameeksha, on 7th of February, purchase goods again 15,000. Tell me.
By purchase account.
By purchase account again. Halima, 10th February, purchase goods from Suryakant, 40,000. On which side of the cash book it will be recorded? Purchase goods from Suryakant. On credit side. Okay. And you will be writing what?
Purchase.
By purchase account, that is. Right?
Yes.
Okay. Sameeksha, is this correct?
So, won't we write by Suryakant account?
Okay. So, you are also incorrect. Both of you are incorrect because...
Oh,
because this time we are purchasing goods from Surya Kant.
So debtors will increase.
Debtors will increase, but we are not concerned about the debtors. No, we will only record the transactions in the cash book which are related to the cash inflow also.
Oh, yes, sir.
So purchase of goods from Surya Kant will not be recorded in the cash book because it is not a cash transaction.
But sir, in the 7th one, purchase goods is not written for cash. So when
Whenever name is written, you will presume that goods has been purchased on credit. If yes. nothing is mentioned or cash is mentioned or cash is mentioned with the name, in all other cases, we will presume that goods has been purchased on cash only. If the cash is mentioned, it is already mentioned that goods are purchased on cash. If nothing is mentioned, we will presume that goods are purchased on cash. If name as well as cash is mentioned, then we will consider that goods has been purchased on cash only.
Yes, sir.
Only if name is mentioned, then we will consider it as a credit purchase. Or if otherwise it's mentioned that we have purchased goods on credit, then we will presume it as credit only.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Halima, paid to Suryakant. Tell me, on which side of the cash book it will
be recorded? Suryakant will be credited.
Okay, so by Suryakant will be written on the credit side of the cash book, right?
Yes.
Very good. And discount received 1200, on which side of the cash book it will be recorded? Discount received. Come on, Halima, I want you to answer this.
We will debit discount
because we are receiving discount 1200, received. Right?
Yes.
Okay. And Halima, what will we do with this particular transaction, discount received?
Debit.
Sameeksha?
The discount received? So there is no cash discount,
yes.
Right?
So discount that's why we won't... Yeah. Yeah, discount received is not related with the cash inflow. Discount received does not indicate that cash is coming into the business. There is no change in the cash. Getting my point, discount received then is amount? Not monetary benefit. This is not, basically it will not be recorded in the cash book, Halima, because discount received is not a monetary benefit. It does not lead to the inflow or outflow of cash. Therefore, it will not be recorded. This will be recorded in the profit and loss account that we will be doing separately. That is a different concept altogether. So for now, discount received does not lead to any inflow of cash. Therefore, it will not be recorded in the cash book. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, next, Sameeksha will answer this. Paid wages in cash. Tell me,
Sameeksha. By wages account.
On the?
Credit side.
On the credit side of the cash book by wages account.
By wages
Okay, 16th transaction paid to casual labor. Tell me, Halima. Paid to casual laborers.
By casual labor account.
By casual labor account, 1500. Correct. On the credit side as well, na?
Yes.
On the yes. Okay.
Credit.
Okay, credit. 20. Sold goes to Devraj for cash. Tell me, Sameeksha.
On cash, right? So to sales account?
To sales account. Sold
goes to Devraj. But Devraj is there.
But cash is also given, no?
Yes, sir. So it will be to sales account, right?
Correct. To sales account on the debit side. All right. Again, paid electricity bill in cash. Halima.
Electricity credited.
Credited. Perfect. Very good. Next, withdrew cash from bank. Sameeksha.
Cash inflow. So, to cash account?
Withdrew cash from
bank. Sorry, to drawing. So, no. For personal, is it? It's not it for is personal,
not,
right?
If it is not mentioned, we will presume that it is for official.
For official. So
cash is increasing now. What matters?
Yes, sir. So,
here
to
is,
cash account, right?
No, okay. In the cash account, you won't be mentioning the cash account itself.
Bank
account.
Oh, yeah.
To bank account.
To bank account, yes.
Very good, Halima. So bank account to bank account will be written in the debit side of the cash book. Received for cash sales, Halima. Received for cash sales.
Sales will be debited.
Sales will be debited, correct. Next, paid for miscellaneous expenses, Sameeksha.
By miscellaneous expenses,
500. So, I hope you have entered all the transaction on the proper side of the cash book. And if you have entered the transaction on the proper side, then you must be getting this as the balance CD. See, this is the balance CD. 1,29,700. And the total balance of the credit side is 3,25,000. And total of the debit side is also 3,25,000.
Sir, can you show the question again?
What is the question?
Sir, yes, sir.
Got it. Any doubt?
No, sir, I got it.
Solution is also clear. The balance is also clear.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
We will do one more question.
Sir, one more.
Okay, so this time we will be doing the multiple, the double column cash book. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in case of double column cash book, the only difference is that we will be recording the bank transaction at the same time. If the transaction is related to bank, then the bank transaction will also be recorded in the double column cash book. And for that, we prepare the two different columns for recording the cash transaction and for recording the bank transaction. Two different columns are made. Is that okay?
Sir. Yes, sir.
All right. So, okay. So this is the question. Prepare the cash book from the following transaction of the Messrs. Advanced Technology Zone for the month of April 2017. So information is cash in hand 14,000, bank overdraft is 13,200. And because we are preparing the multiple column cash book, so we will be recording both the transactions. We will be recording the transaction related to cash, as well as we will also record the transaction related to banks. So tell me, cash in hand will be recorded on which side, first of all? Cash in hand will be recorded on which side of the cash book and which column of the cash book? Tell me, Sameeksha.
Cash in hand. Sir, by balance BD?
By balance, that means it will be recorded in the credit side of the cash book. Sameeksha.
Sir, I get 1 minute.
Cash in hand. This is a positive balance or the negative balance, Sameeksha?
Positive.
Positive.
And so it will be in the debit side.
Yeah, and by what name we will be writing
to
it?
To balance BD.
Perfect, to balance BD. And bank overdraft will be written?
By balance BD.
By balance BD on the credit side.
Credit side.
Okay, very good. Now, Halima will answer this. On April 4, we are paying for the wages. If nothing is mentioned, just presume that we are paying it through cash, not by bank. Tell me now.
We'll credit wages.
We will credit the wages In which column? Cash column or the bank column?
Cash.
We are now cash column, right? Okay. Okay, Samiksha, next transaction. Cash sales.
To sales account in the debit side.
In the debit side of the?
Cash column. Cash column.
Okay. Next, purchase goods from Rahul for rupees 12,250, paid by check in full settlement, 12,000 only. Tell me, Halima, purchase goods from Rahul.
Here, check is given, so in bank column it will go.
Yes, it will be recorded in the bank column, correct? That is right. So,
credit?
But
Rahul.
Okay, so we will be recording by, we will Rahul. Be writing the name. No, because we are paying the check, no? We are making the payment. We are not buying the goods on credit. Therefore, we will not be mentioning the name of the supplier. Halima, getting my point? When we buy goods, either on cash or by bank or by check, we don't write the name of the supplier. We write down the name of the supplier only when we purchase the goods on credit basis. Is that okay?
So here purchase will come.
Yes, very good. Purchase account will be credited. Right?
Yes,
by purchase account. And what will be the amount? How much we are paying? We are paying only 12,000 instead of 12,250. So we are getting a discount of how much? We are getting a discount of 250.
250.
But discount will not be recorded anywhere in the cash book, right?
Yes.
Okay. So the on 7th April, we will be recording 12,000 only on the credit side of the bank column. Because yes, we are paying it through check, no?
All
right. On April 9, Samiksha will answer this. We are purchasing furniture for cash.
By furniture account.
In which column?
In credit, which side, credit side cash column by furniture account.
Very good. Halima, next question. Cash paid to Rohit, discount received 105,000. That means total amount payable to Rohit was actually 5,100, but we have got a discount of 100 rupees. Therefore, we are paying only 5,000. So ultimately, cash is paid to Rohit. Tell me on which
so
side
in
of
cash
the account.
Account. Rohit will credit.
Rohit will be credited.
Credit
in which
side?
Column?
Cash.
Cash. Okay. Samiksha, cash sales.
To sales account in the cash column, debit side.
Perfect. Halima, bank charge interest on overdraft. Bank charge interest on overdraft. So bank will increase or reduce, first of all?
Bank charges, so it will increase.
Bank charge interest, no? So bank,
bank
will charge.
Sorry, I mean.
Okay, so bank, when bank will charge.
It will decrease.
It will lead
yes,
to
from
the
here it will decrease.
Correct. So when bank will charge interest, this will lead to the reduction in the value of bank. So this will be credited. And yes, we will be writing by bank charges. Correct. By bank charges will be credited.
Sir, bank column, right?
Yeah, it will be recorded in the bank column only.
Yes.
Next is deposited into bank. 7,000. We are depositing 7,000 in the bank. Now this is
Sir, this
will be contra entry,
right? Because
yeah, this will be contra entry because when we deposited 7,000 into bank, it means that we must be depositing cash into the bank. This will lead to the reduction of cash as well as increase in the value of bank at the same time. So
yes,
debit and credit side of the cash book will simultaneously get affected. All right.
Yes.
So deposited into bank, that means
First of all,
on the debit side, we will be recording what?
To cash account
in the bank column.
Bank
7,000.
Yes, sir.
And on the credit side, we will be writing
by bank account in the cash column.
7,000. All right. Halima, is this clear to
yes,
you as well?
Yes, I got it.
Okay. On April 20, paid telephone bill by check. Halima, answer this. Paid telephone bill by check. On which side of the cash book it will be recorded, in which column it will be recorded, and by what name it will be recorded?
By telephone bill, it will be recorded in credit side.
In which column?
Bank.
Very good. Samiksha, tell me the entry for the 25th April. Sold goods for rupees 23,500 to Vikas and received a check in full settlement. deposit at same day 23,000.
So it will be two sales account in the debit side and bank on. So because it's received check.
Correct. Okay. Paid rent. Halima, paid rent.
Credited cash column.
Cash column. And the name will be?
Rent will write. Buy rent
account. Correct. Okay. Sameeksha, drew cash for personal use.
Personal use. So buy drawings account in the credit side.
Okay.
Yeah.
In which column?
Cash column.
Cash column. Paid salary 2000. Sameeksha.
By salary account. Okay. 2000 cash.
Interest collected by bank. Halima, please. Interest collected by bank.
We'll credit interest in bank column.
Sir, debit, right? Because it's
interest collected as an income.
Income. So to interest debit account.
Right, to interest account.
Bank column.
See, this
it's
is
our income or bank's income interest.
See, it depends. See, Halima, here it is mentioned that bank is collecting interest collected. That means this is our income collected by the bank. If it was written that interest charged by bank, that means bank is charging interest. That is an expense. Okay. But if it is written that interest is collected by the bank, that means bank is actually paying interest. Bank is actually collecting your interest. You must have invested in some securities, debenture or something like that. And against that investment, you are receiving certain amount of interest. And bank, on behalf of you, is accepting that interest. That is interest collected by the bank, 2500. So this will be recorded on the debit side of the cash flow. Okay, so this is it. This is the double column cash book, and I hope everything is clear to Halima and Sameeksha and Steve as well.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So
you want me to do one more question, or is this sufficient? Okay, for now, I think it is okay. Can we move to the other chapter? Let's talk about the. Tell me which chapter you want me to recall. Revise you. Tell me the name of any one chapter.
So can we do accounting equation again?
Yeah, sure.
Sir, I know it's simple, but after doing all this.
Yeah, no problem. That's okay. So we will be doing the accounting question. Just a minute. Let me open the PowerPoint for that.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, according to CBSE, we have MCQs. So from accounting equation, we did not do MCQs. Can we do that also?
Sameeksha, I don't have the MCQs right now.
Sir, not but today, but next time.
Yeah, okay. I'll prepare the MCQs for this chapter as well. And
a cash book also.
Cash book. And I think we didn't do the MCQs for the journal entries as well, right?
Yes, sir. Many we did not do.
Okay. So because I'll try.
Theory, yes.
Okay, no problem. So I'll try. And yes. I'll prepare the MCQs for these chapters. We'll discuss the MCQs in the upcoming sessions. Don't worry.
Yes, sir.
Is the accounting equation slide visible to all of you?
Yes, sir. We can see.
Okay. In the accounting equation, we have, first of all, we have discussed the meaning of accounting equation, wherein I have told you that accounting equation is what? Accounting equation is just a mathematical expression that says the assets of the firm is always equals to the liability and capital of the firm, right? Accounting equation is a mathematical expression that shows the asset and liability of a firm are equal. Are you able to recall this?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And if you remember, we have made the equation like this. We have accounting equation can be written as total asset equal to total claims. That can be further simplified as asset equal to liability plus capital, right? So yes. This is the main accounting equation on the basis of which we will be doing questions. So asset equal to liability plus capital. And also if you want to find out the value of liability, then in that case, you can simply reduce the value of capital from the value of assets. And if you want to find out the value of capital, then in that case, you just have to reduce the value of liability from the value of assets. That's it. Got it?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So after that, we have discussed before starting the questions based on accounting equation. I have told you that in accounts, there is a concept which is called duality principle or duality aspect concept. Dual aspect concept. According to dual aspect concept, every transaction have at least two effect, right? I have told you that.
Yes, sir. Debit and credit.
Every transaction have two effects, two aspects, debit aspect and the credit aspect. Or you can say, just forgot the debit and credit part. Just for the time being, you just keep that in mind. Every transaction have at least two effect. That means every transaction will affect two areas of business. So let's understand how this happens. See, for example, purchase goods in business for rupees 10,000, right? When we purchase goods for rupees 10,000, what will happen? Firstly, it will lead to increase in the value of asset in the form of goods, and it will also reduce the value of cash in the available in the business, right? So two effect will be cash decreases and goods increases. Is that okay, Samiksha and Halima?
Yes.
Okay. And we have done few more examples based on this, like purchase goods for rupees 20,000 on credit from Anju. When we purchase goods from Anju on credit, what will happen? First of all, goods will increase, and at the same time, creditor will also increase by the same amount. Goods will increase by 20,000, creditor will also increase by 20,000. Is this okay, Samiksha and Halima?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And tell me, what will be the effect of this transaction? Tell me the effect of this transaction. Goods purchased for rupees 10,000 on cash, 5,000 on credit. Tell me what areas, what are the different things that will get affected due to this transaction?
Goods will increase by 15,000,
correct.
And cash will decrease by 10,000.
Cash will decrease by 10,000, correct. And
creditor will also increase by
5,000. That is right. So there are three effects of this transaction. So dual aspect concept or duality principle does not say that every transaction will have only two effects. There can be more than two effects also, but at least two effects will arise. All right, let's move to the next transaction. Just a minute, next concept. In the same chapter, I have also told you that capital, I think both of you know the meaning of capital, right? What is capital?
Yes,
capital is the amount invested by the owner of the business into the business, right?
Yes, sir.
So do you have any idea how the value of capital increases? So it is very simple. Capital increases with the further investment or when more revenue is generated by the business.
Yes.
Capital increases in two situations. Increase in the revenue or increase in the level of investment. And it decreases in two situations, when there is decrease in the revenue or there is reduction in the investment.
The revenue also includes that profit, right?
Yes, yes. The revenue and profit is the same thing, yes, for now. There is a difference between the profit and revenue, but for now you can take it
for
as
here. It's okay.
Yeah. So paid rent for rupees 25,000. So see, first of all, rent is what? Rent is an expense. And we are paying it. We are paying rent of 25,000. That means we must be paying rent by cash.
Cash.
Okay. So this transaction will reduce the overall cash available, and this will also increases the expense. Therefore, the capital will decrease. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So effect of this transaction will be cash will be reduced. Rent will be rent is an expense. Therefore, capital will reduce. Asset will reduce. Halima, is this clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now Halima will answer me how this is going to affect the business. Cash withdrew rupees 10,000 from bank. This one is very
drawing
simple.
Drawing account debited
no,
to bank.
No, this is not drawing. This is not drawing. Where it is written that the cash has been withdrawn for personal use. Unless and until cash is withdrawn for the personal use, you cannot use the term drawings. Drawings will only be used when the cash has been withdrawn for personal use. All right. This time,
sir,
cash is withdrawn. Yes.
Sir, drawings in accounting equation will decrease the capital.
Yeah.
Sir, just asking general.
Yeah. Drawings reduces the capital. This time, this is not considered as a drawing because cash is cash.
Yes,
we are withdrawing cash from bank. That means cash will
Top
increase.
Offices.
Yeah. Cash will increase and bank will
and
reduce.
Bank is capital.
Bank is capital.
Sir, our bank is, yeah. Bank.
So asset will
asset.
Increase in the form of cash and
yes.
bank will reduce in the form of asset will reduce also and in the form of bank.
Yes, sir.
Halima, this is clear?
Yes.
Okay. And let's do one or two more examples. Bank provided interest. So Halima will answer how this transaction will affect the business. Bank provided interest. So what will happen due to this transaction? Do it fast.
Interest account debited to bank.
I'm not asking for the general entry. I'm just asking what will be the effect of this transaction. What two things that will get affected due to this? What will increase? What will decrease?
Here we'll get cash and bank will decrease.
Okay. See, Halima, whenever bank pays interest, bank provide interest, it get credited into the bank account itself. That means when bank pays you interest, the bank balance will increase. Getting my point?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, so basically bank will increase due to this transaction. Number one. And tell me, interest is a revenue or as an or it is an expense?
Revenue
or it is an expense, Halima. Bank provided interest.
Revenue.
It is a revenue for you or it is an expense? Revenue, correct. And as I told you, whenever there is a revenue, what will
capital
get affected?
Increases.
Capital will get affected, right? And capital will increase whenever there is a revenue. So effect of this transaction will be bank will increase and bank will increase. That is asset will increase and capital will also increase at the same time.
Yes,
Halima.
Sir.
Is this clear, Halima?
Yes.
So I think you have understood what is the concept of duality principle. Let's now discuss the accounting equation directly. So see, this is the question. Prepare the accounting equation from the following information. And I hope that you remember the format of accounting equation.
Yes.
You remember, no? So see, we have this kind of format. We write the, we have to make three columns for the serial number, then for the transaction. Then asset equals to liability plus capital. All right. Are you able to recall this?
Yes.
Yes.
Halima. Okay. Now we will be recording the same transaction on that particular format. So first of all, started business with cash. Tell me, when we start business with cash, what will increase in the business? How this will be recorded in the accounting equation format? Halima will answer this first.
Here capital will increase
and also
cash will increase.
So we will be writing it as like this. Cash will increase by 45,000 and capital will also increase by 45,000. And always remember that you, after every transaction, you have to ensure that asset must be equal to liability plus capital. So by drawing this line, we can calculate the total of the liability plus capital side and the asset side. So we can see that capital is 45,000. We have no liability. And on the asset side, we have just cash. So 45,000 of cash is equal to the 45,000 of capital. That means accounting
yes.
equation is proven.
Yes.
All right. Next, open a bank account with a deposit of 4,500. Samisha will answer this.
Cash will decrease by 4,500 and bank will increase by 4,500.
Correct. So cash is reducing by 4,500. Bracket indicate minus. All right. Bracket indicate that value is reducing. So 4,500 is reduced in the cash, but bank increases at the same time. After entering every transaction, we will total the we will make a new accounting equation, right?
Yes.
So now the new accounting equation stands at cash we have 40,500, bank we have 4,500. And on the other hand, liability plus capital side, we have only capital 45,000. So 45,000 and this is also 45,000. So both the sides are tallying. That is that means accounting equation proves. Next, the final transaction, bought good from Messrs. Sun and Company for 11,200. Tell me on which side of the how this will be recorded in the accounting equation. Halima will answer this. Bought goods from Messrs. Sons and Company for 11,200.
Here, goods will increase.
Mm-hmm.
And cash and will decrease.
No, cash will not decrease. Because we are buying from Messrs. Sons and Company. And because name is mentioned, we will presume that goods must have been bought on credit only. Right, Halima?
Okay.
So, because we are buying goods, so definitely there will be good increase in the value of the stock or the goods will increase. But at the same time, creditor will also increase by 11,200. So this will be recorded in the format like this. Stock will increase by 11,200. You can also write goods. Goods will increase by 11,200. And at the same time, creditor is also increasing by 11,200.
Okay.
Okay. Now we can total both the sides, assets and the liability plus capital side. So we have got on the asset side, we have got cash and we have got bank, we have got stock. So collectively, the total value of the asset will be how much? It will be 45 and
56,200,
correct. 56,200. And on the liability plus capital side as well, when we total the creditor plus capital, we will get the same answer. All right, Halima and
yes,
Samiksha. Okay, let's discuss one more question, then we will end this session.
Yes.
So, tell me the general entry for this one. Sorry, not general. Tell me how the following transaction will be recorded. Prepare the accounting equation from the following transaction. Firstly, Raju started business with rupees 1 lakh. Tell me.
So cash will increase and capital will increase.
Correct. Okay. And he opened a bank account and deposited 20,000.
So cash will decrease and bank will increase.
Perfect. Very good. Halima will now answer. He bought furniture for business for rupees 10,000.
Yeah, furniture will increase and cash will decrease.
Correct. Now, Samiksha. For fourth transaction, he bought goods for business.
Will increase and cash will decrease.
Very good. Fifth one, Halima. He also sold goods costing 10,000 for rupees 12,000.
Cash will increase and their goods will decrease.
Okay, cash will increase by how much?
Cash at 12,000.
And goods will increase by how much?
Goods value at 10,000.
10,000. So the difference
between
the
profit of 2,000.
Yeah, there is a profit of 2,000, no?
We'll add that in capital.
And because we are having a profit of 2,000, this profit capital will increase the overall capital.
Yes.
Correct? Halima?
Yes.
Okay, so this profit will be recorded in the under the capital. So see, 20,000. Sorry, fifth one. No? So 12,000 of cash will increase by 12,000. But goods will reduce only by 10,000, right? And there is a profit of 2,000. So the overall capital will increase by 2,000. Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Halima, is this okay?
Yes, sir, I got it. Yes.
For the sixth transaction, Raju paid salary for rupees 10,000.
Sir, cash will decrease.
Cash will decrease.
And salary is going to...
Sir, salary is an expense, right?
Salary is an expense, correct.
So capital will decrease?
Yeah, that is right. So salary will cash will decrease and capital will also decrease. So cash will decrease by 10,000, capital will also decrease.
And sir, if it's outstanding salary, then it's a separate, it's a liability, right?
Yeah, in that case, it will be a liability.
Yes, sir.
So he also borrowed 30,000 from bank for business. Halima will answer this.
Will decrease and cash will increase by 30,000.
Cash will increase, that is correct. But yes. Why bank will decrease?
He borrowed.
Borrowed does not mean we have withdrawn funds from our bank account. We have borrowed from some other bank. So borrowing is what? It is a liability, no?
Yes.
So if it is a liability, So therefore, it should be recorded under the
in the liabilities account.
Correct. In the liability, under the liability by the name creditors or borrowing.
Yes.
So 30,000 will be added in the cash and borrowings or the creditor will be increased under the liability. So liability will increase by 30,000 and cash will increase by 30,000. Now you can create the new equation, new accounting equation or the final accounting equation. We will get these values. Cash will be 52,000, bank 50,000, furniture 10,000, goods 10,000. And on the other hand, liability plus capital equals to 92,000, 30,000.
Yes, sir. 112.
Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So I think this is enough for the accounting equation part. I hope everything that we have done in this chapter is somewhat you are able to recall a little.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just a minute. Can we do one more chapter? 10. We have 10 minutes more. So yes. Let's discuss one more chapter. Which chapter?
Sir,
mm-hmm.
There are many MCQs from the first chapter theory, I think. The concept based that like we did dual aspect. So like that there are many
concepts, we are yet to discuss all the theoretical part.
Yes.
We have just I have basically
done the practical.
So there are few more chapters which are theory based. So yes. We will be doing, there are various principles, matching principle, duality principle, all of those principles,
yes,
and concepts. We will be doing that in the later part of the the next sessions.
Okay.
So actually the remaining chapter that is left in your syllabus is all theoretical part. We have done all the practical, all the numerical chapters. Only those chapters are still left, which is of theoretical. So we'll be doing in the next sessions.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Probably we will start first of all on Saturday. Possibly we will be starting basis of accounting. So there are two bases of accounting, cash basis accounting and the accrual basis accounting. We will be discussing that. And after that, we will discuss the various accounting principles.
Yes.
Okay. So, all right, let's talk about the subsidiary books.
Yes, sir.
Remember subsidiary books?
Yes, sir. Sales book, purchase book.
Yeah, okay.
Sales return, purchase return.
Journal proper.
Yes.
Very good. Nice. So let's do one question based on the subsidiary books only. Tell me if this slide is visible to all of you.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay. So in the subsidiary book, first of all, we have discussed the meaning of, we have discussed the various types of subsidiary book. And I have told you that cash book is itself a subsidiary book.
Yes.
And other than cash book, we have other subsidiary book, purchase book, sales book, purchase return, sales return, journal proper, all of these. And in this chapter, we have first started understanding the meaning of purchase book, wherein I have explained that purchase book is a kind of subsidiary book, which only record the purchase related transaction, and only those goods are recorded in which we deals in, right? Credit purchase are recorded in the purchase book, and that too for those goods only in which we deals in. All right. So
yes.
There are few features of the purchase book that we have also done, and I think because the features are very easy, so there is no need to revise these for now. You can easily cover the features. So let's skip this. This is the format of the purchase book. As I've told you that there are five, six columns in the purchase book. Date column particular, then we have invoice number. This invoice number indicates the purchase invoice number. In the sales book, we have the sales invoice number. In the purchase return book, we have the debit note number. In the sales return, we have credit note number. All right. So
yes.
Then we have ledger folio, then detail of the goods that we have purchased and the final amount of the goods that we have purchased. Okay. So let's revise the purchase book through this question. First of all, see, Verma Brothers Kolkata carry on business as a wholesale cloth dealer from the following write up the purchase books for January. So whenever you read the question, just keep this in mind. The most important area that you need to focus is that what kind of business what kind of business is there. So in this question, there is a cloth business, right? The Verma brothers are wholesaler of clothes. So make sure that whenever you are recording any transaction, the purchase book, all those transactions must be recorded to the sale of clothes only.